closer. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Well, today here I am in the van. It's before we open up the fireworks store, and I'm just going through my rituals of opening up the fireworks stand. And the first thing is I have to get my rock and roll on. So I pull the van over here in the morning, and for about 10 or 15 minutes, I crank up the music and get my head wrapped around the day with a little, well, today is ZZ Top, all right? But generally, it could be Van Halen. It might be Quiet Riot, Motley Crue, you know, just some rock and roll to get me going in the morning. And after that, it's all about getting over here and opening up the store. So let's go ahead and do the first steps of that, shall we? Check this out. All right, sometimes, as you can see, we have the U-Haul truck here in the morning, and they're generally getting fireworks or bringing fireworks, and they distribute them all around. So Dalton out there probably is going to get some fireworks, it looks like, who knows. But they are setting up more tents and getting ready for the 4th of July festivities. In my case, I'm not going to really be dealing with that. I'm just going to go ahead and open up our shop. So let's do that. So what I've done this morning is I've opened up our storage area locker here and gotten out some of the merchandise and set up our register and all of that good stuff. We got Christy behind us. She runs the register, and it took a little bit of work to get everything updated in this particular system. I was the first guy to actually put it together and get it actually working so we could actually do something with it. And Christy is the one who has become the wizard of it. She's used this type of thing in the past, kind of doing it once again. And she's got it down where all the prices of everything are in there. And that's the tax that had to be included, various changes that had to be made, and item numbers and that type of thing. But we've worked through that, so it makes it easier when people come up to the stand to know and to check in their merchandise and get an accurate price amount. The other thing is we had to price everything at the tables inside of the tent in order for people to know right off the top of their head exactly what the price was of those items. So that was a big process so far in the last week that we've been here. There had to be some changes even after we did the first pricing, because there was a mistake made down the line, not on our end, but of the pricing and the fact that our prices weren't set for the buy one, get one that we're offering here. And so we had to go back and change everything over. So something you could encounter if you ever decided to do this, things will sneak up. And you're going to have to go ahead and take care of them or just shut down, one of the two. But we choose to take care of them, move forward, and that's what we're doing. So check this out, guys. There are a few other things you have to worry about in the morning, such as counting in the till, facing all of the inventory, and making sure the open signs are open. once you get all of this done, things kind of slow down for the day, and that is until you get a few people in to buy a whole bunch of fireworks. This is when it's time to get your razzle-dazzle on. Well, folks, so what have we learned so far? Well, quite a few things. It takes a little more than meets the eye to kind of sell at one of these fireworks stands, or any stand that's a temporary business where you have a short amount of time to get the job done. All you can do as a guy who's trying to survive that kind of onslaught, and that is a lot of dead time, and then a little bit of, you know, hardcore pace for a little bit. Well, what you have to do is make it kind of an even keel, and that's what I try to do. And I lay it all out in a graph beforehand. And how that works is just like this. Take a look. So when I do something like this, I need to get a good vision of my goals. And how I do it is with this basic little chart here. It starts from the bottom up, beginning with my goal of getting to the location, and then how much money I need to make, and then what my bonus goals are. Each goal is a $1,000 increment, and each main goal is 5 increments. There's a total of 40 $1,000 increments, which makes my 10% cut $4,000. So you can see that I kind of project what I want to happen in a fashion that I can visibly see it, and I do it in increments that I can kind of manage. And so for me, that is how I do it. How you may choose to do it, if you choose to do it at all, is completely up to you, and you'll probably come up with your own methods. Another thing you notice that I ramble on about is the trooper, and why. Why do you constantly talk about the stupid trooper? Well, because it's just that. It's a stupid trooper, but he's my number one salesman. I knew if I had that stupid trooper out here in front or where people could take a picture of him, he would be a great salesperson. And how does that work is that a lot of people come up and actually just come to take a picture of the trooper with them standing next to it, even though they don't buy fireworks. They'll send that to about 100 different people on their Facebook or whatever and tell them where they took that picture. The next thing you know, there's other people there either wanting to take a picture of the stormtrooper or wanting to buy fireworks and take a picture. So what we started doing is actually taking pictures of people with the product that they bought in front of the stormtrooper. This is kind of a neat thing that you can do here. And then what I've added to make that even better is I've added soundtrack to it, and that is some Star Wars music playing lightly in the background. It's not too obtrusive, it's not rock and roll, it's not country, it's not any of that. It's something that gives what we're doing a theme. And speaking of theme, I didn't have a lot to work with here, but you might notice some of the camo fabric. I did buy that at a yard sale for really cheap. Christy wondered why I was going to buy it. I bought it for reasons like we're seeing right now, and that is to give our little space here a theme. And what is the theme? I'm thinking of it as kind of an outpost of a Star Wars movie, and where we have some camo net because maybe we're militarized, and we have the star background where you have that Star Wars kind of look. I started putting the camo fabric on top of the tablecloth, like a tablecloth, so it ties everything in. And I'll kind of continue that up until our really peak moment, where when you come in, it really feels like we have a flavor. In fact, you'll see me wearing very soon an Obi-Wan Kenobi, very light, easy to wear costume. That's going to tie in with all of this, and I'll be the local trader who's trying to sell you the fireworks for the upcoming event that's here on our strange planet. Okay, so that's my intention, and it's really working well. We didn't sell a lot of things to begin with, but we did get an audience, and that audience was interested enough to come back and see what we're up to. And every time they come back, I've made little changes, tweaks, and different things to the landscape to make them go, wow, things are different here. And now with the music and hopefully some new lighting, we're going to give it even more of an edge. And that's all I can say to you guys out there that are trying to do this sort of thing, that you are thinking on that level. For one, you're thinking, what do the kids like? Because if the kids like it, the mom's going to like it. And if the mom likes it, dad's definitely going to like it. And how can I tie all those three things together to form one big solid block of goodness for the entire family? And for me, it was a Star Wars theme, because the entire family loves that. It's all generations. Everyone knows about it. I've carried those different products with Star Wars in mind whenever we do these types of things. So something to keep in mind, I thought I'd give you the lowdown of what I do to run a fireworks stand. And of course, Christie's behind the scenes, or in front of the scenes, main stage really, taking your money, making you feel good about giving it to her, and giving you explanations as to what the fireworks can do. That's also what I do. I have a little more fun at it. I think I'm a little more laid back about it, but it works, and we have gained an audience, and that audience is now really buying fireworks, and they're a return audience. So it's turning out all right. Well, I'll keep you informed as to what our progress is, how we're doing, and if we survive this storm. All right, guys, stay tuned. I've got more coming from the RV bandwagon right about now. Check this out. Well, guys, here we are on the e-bike, and I try to make this part of my daily ritual. That's go for a little ride, either before or after work, after we've done the fireworks stand, and get my mind off of that stuff and just get out and see what's going on in the countryside. So I take out the e-bike and kind of look for new and interesting places. And this is a loop that I found that takes you around maybe about 2 or 3 miles and puts you right back at the fireworks stand. It's kind of a nice little getaway. Get out and get some cool air. And I highly recommend it. If you have a bike and you're doing this kind of thing, take a little time out, go check out the sights, and get your mind off of it for a minute. It really helps. As this is my first time selling fireworks, I've noticed a few things about selling them, and that is, these are really big fireworks with really big prices, and so you have to kind of own it in order to sell it. And this area is kind of desolate, so we don't have a lot of customers coming by, and those that come in, you have to let them know that this is the place they want to be to buy their fireworks. And how do I do that? I believe it's through trust. That's right, I talk to them on a friendly level, kind of get to know who they are, and by the end of the conversation, we have a little bit of trust. And this type of connection can translate into future sales through different people, that is, their friends and relatives that they might give you a reference for. And that's where every good sale starts, is with that connection to your customer. I hope I've made a connection with you through this video, and that you have a better understanding of how I approach selling fireworks out here in Effingham, Illinois. I'd like you to consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. It does help the channel grow. Thank you for watching this episode of the RV Bandwagon, and I've got more coming your way right about now. Check this out.